Back to the channel, and in this video I am going to show you how to get full score on this lab. So let's get started. So first of all, just log in with your credentials and activate your Cloud Shell. It will ask for done. So it's activated. Now scroll down a little bit and copy this command and paste over here, then click on authorize. So we have done with the task number one. Okay, done. Now for the task two, search for the first of all data fusion, then search for the IAM. Okay, now if you are doing the lab and it's still creating for you, so just we have to wait for that. And it might take around 10 to 20 minutes to complete this process. So yeah, keep wait. If you face like this kind of issue, like just click on this create option. So do not worry about that, it take time. Simply click on the instance again, and now you can see the instance is created, and it took around 15 minutes to complete it. So now just simply click on the instance name, then copy the service account and go to IAM, then click on grant access, then click paste over here. If you just scroll down, copy this role like this and paste over here and select this. Now click on save. Now please pay attention. Click on this checkbox, scroll down at bottom, you will get datafusion.img.serviceaccount.com. So just copy this thing, then go to service account. Then click on this first option, then go to permissions, then click on grant access, paste over here that service account, then click on add role, and now here we have to view. So if you want, you can click on this check my progress, so just check the score, you are done. Now copy this service account user, do not copy that full stops, then click on add new role and paste over here and choose the second one, and done. So we have done with that. Now we have to give one more permissions. So if you just scroll down, copy this DLP administrator, then go to IAM, then click on this checkbox and add bottom the last second. Click on this editor, edit principle of pencil icon, then click on add another rule and paste that DLP administrator and click on save. So we have done with the task number 3. Now if you just click on check my progress, it will take few seconds to update the score, so do not worry about that. Meanwhile, click on this view instance. So now it's done. Now it's time for task number 4. So just click on this, authorize it. It will take few seconds to establish a connection, so do not worry about that. Click on no thanks, then click on this hamburger icon, then click on the studio. So it's done. Now we have to create one pipeline, so click on allow, and in the source section, make sure you have choose the source section. If you just scroll down, you will see GCS. Click on that, then click on the properties and remove these two things. Okay, now if you just scroll down, here is the reference name. You can give any name, but I'm just giving for the test, so I will give the test like this. If you just scroll down, you can copy this thing like this and paste over here. And my recommendation for you, you must use the test, so it will be easy for you in the future tasks. For the format, come over here and choose the CSV like this, and we have done. So now we have to add all these things, so just copy this and click on this field name and paste over here, then hit enter and do the same thing for remaining like this. And this is the last one like this, then click on all these check boxes. So it's, we are done with this thing, and from here you can cross verify that you have done this correct way. Okay, so we have not done with that. Now just click on validate. So no error found. You can just simply click on this cross. So we have done with task number 5. Now it's time to task number 6. So task number 7. So simply click on hub. Then you, if you want, you can search, or you can, if you just scroll down, you will get data loss prevention. So click on that. Then click on deploy. Then click on finish. Then you can simply click on this cross and this cross. No need to wait for that. So we have done with the task number 7. Now it's time to task number 8. So come over here and search for data loss prevention. So you will get this option. Now we have to create one custom template. So click on this configuration, then click on create template. For the template ID, if you want, you can give any name, but I am giving the same name as I gave earlier. So I am giving test, and please, if you're giving the another name, so please make sure that, or you can just copy this thing to your quick notes or anything, because we need in the future step. So give the name, then click on continue. Now please pay attention. Click on this manage info types, and now from here, search for phone, and you will get this phone space number, not this is phone underscore number. Choose the second one, phone number. Okay, then choose for or, and then choose for email address. This is the second one. Okay, this is one. Okay, like this. Now click on this check boxes like that. Now click on done and click on create. It will take few seconds and it will be created the template. So it's created now. So if you just come over here and click on check my progress, so it's done. Now we have to come back to our Data Fusion, Cloud Fusion, and now click on this transform, and from the transform window we have to choose Google DLP retract, then join this thing like this, then click on the properties, then click on this enable this checkbox for the template ID. If you remember, we have created one template ID called test, so just give the name over here like this, test. Okay, now here, from here choose masking, and now from here choose custom template. Sometime it's chosen or sometime it's just show the none, so do not worry about that. And from here choose notes, and now here type hash like this, and we have done with all these things. Now simply click on this validate, so no error found, and you can click on this cross. So we have done with the task number 9. So we have done all these steps. Okay, now it's time to task number 10. So what we have to create, one node also. So if you just click on this sync, then search for the GCS, and now add this thing to here like this, and then click on the properties, and this kind of tool you will get. Now for the reference name, type test2. For the path, copy your project ID and type first of all GS colon forward slash, two times forward slash. Let me just so increase the font size so that you can, yeah, like this. Now paste your project ID and then again give one forward slash like this. Now for format, come over here and choose CSV like this. Let me just zoom out, so your page also look like this. Now click on just validate. So no error found, click on this cross box. So we have done all these things. Now if you just scroll down, so yeah, no need to do the task 11, task 12. So here we have to add like our email address, but we already done in the previous step, so no need to do. If you haven't done, you can perform this step and you will get a score. Now this is the most important task of the lab. So what we have to do, click on this name option, you can give any name. I'm just giving quick lab, and in the description box you can type anything. Please like, share and subscribe. Okay, if you want you can give any name, or yeah, so click on the save, then it will take few seconds. So it's done. Now click on deploy, it will take few seconds. So it's done. Now click on this run option, and from here you can look at your status. So for in the starting it will be provisioning, then starting, then running, and then succeed. So it will around took 10 to 15 minutes, so kindly wait for that. Okay, and that's how we can complete this lab with the full score. I already created one lab where we have to just complete the lab, but yeah, it will if you are the part of the game it won't give the score, but yeah, the lab will successful you for you. But now if from these steps we can get a full score also. So now just wait for 10 to 15 minutes and let's see.
So after 30 minutes
It succeed. So yeah, that's long it take to complete that last task. So if you have any doubts, like guys, please let me know in the comment sections. And that's the reason why I create one short video, and this is a full video of the lab. Please let me know if you have any doubts. Thanks for watching. Have a good day, guys.